Hello and I welcome you to my video classes on water resource management. And today we are mainly discussing private sector involvements in integrated water resource management. Myself Vishwanath, our team, and we'll see that today's content mainly what actually we are discussing in this video. We are discussing mainly about introduction and role or motive or need, then forms of private sector involvement types, right? So now we'll understand what you mean by private sector involvements, right? So private sector is attracted to invest in environmental protection through regulations, legislations and specific incentives, right? So here the mainly focuses is we have to make some good legislations, means some rules and regulations for legalization, and regulations and specific incentives means we have to make encouragement of the private companies to invest. So mainly it is what related to government has to make some rules and regulations that should be company friendly, and even has to be motivate the private companies to come and invest in the developmental activities, right? And nowadays it is becoming a main main importance. Why? Because government has to take many works. The government is not only focusing on water resource development, it has to take care of the educational developments, even it has to take the industrial developments, even has to take many works. So that's what government do not have sufficient fund to invest in a water resource development to make the developmental activities work good and even faster condition, then it required the investment. That investment it is trying to take from the private sectors, that is called as investments, right? And then the main what government is expecting from the private sectors, from government is mainly expecting financing through investment in the services, financing through investment in a services like water supply, like a sanitations, even irrigation schemes and construction of dams, providing canals, drip irrigations, that will be invested by the private companies. Then, and from where they will get the money actually? Even government has to get some money, and even private sector also has to take the money. So some private sectors are there, they will get money from the investors, right, from the shareholders. Even some companies are there, they will borrow the money from the some commercial banks, some institutes or financial institutes. For example, World Bank will give some loans, even Asian Development Bank will give some loans, even some public sector banks in the countries, they will provide the loan for the developmental activities, right? So they required financial investment, and that investment will be taken from the commercial banks or financial institutes. And you should not think that it is not completely privatization or complete is a private property. No, actually it is only to attract to invest, and remaining things will be there under the government only. It is government property, or it will be controlled by government rules and regulations, make sure that people are getting a good benefited from the structures. So then we have to understand we will discuss about mainly role of private sector involvement or motive behind the involvement of the private sectors, or even it is known as need for private sector involvements. So why actually needed, right? So here mainly four points are there, and now it is very important. Why? Because main involvement is based on these four points. One is financial. So financial means what? It is an investment. Government passes on the cost and work of rising fund. So we know the construction activities or water supply, sanitation, infrastructure is not a small thing. It required a huge investment. That huge investment, it is not possible from the government. Even it is possible, but it will take more time. So instead of 1 year, it may take 10 years. So that's what it is, a slow developmental activities. If you want to get a rapid developmental activities, then investment is required. But government is don't have sufficient fund, and it is getting some problem. So that's what government is motivating the private companies to invest. So the burden of investment or budgeting from the government is reducing by taking the help of financial help of the private sectors. Next is political requirements. Not political requirement means election. It is related to work distribution. If you want to complete the work or management work or service work, they require some manpower, right? then they require some recruitment. But here that manpower is reducing by providing the political power towards the private sectors. For example, reducing the work, mainly it is collection of unpaid bill, or increasing the tariffs, and mainly it is reducing the workforce from the government organization. Why? Because some of the works is given to private organization. They are doing collection of bills or making some maintenance work and even construction activities, right? It's not entirely not taken by the government. Then it is providing some burden. Actually, it has to be completed from the government organization. Because of some problem, they are giving the political power even to the private sectors. Next is expertise. We know in a government offices or government authorities, very less manpower will be there. And they have to handle the administrative work, as well as management work, as well as technical work. So it will become a burden. So that even they are taking that, even private sectors, they have a good expertise in international level laws, as well as national level laws, as well as the new technology to manage the resource, as well as new methods of construction activities, that all will come from private sector involvement. Next is, even government will think in terms of risk sharing, because huge amount of money is investing from to make the construction activities. But if investment is not returned back or investment is not coming, then here risk will be shared by government, as well as it will be shared by public interest as well as the private organizations. I'll repeat, one is financial requirement, means we are reducing the burden of government to invest, and that burden will be reduced by increasing the invest from the private organizations. Next is political requirement. Political requirement means making contract workers or non-government workers, reducing the manpower of non-government workers to do the works, to do the implementation, management, and executions. Next is expertise. So they want to improve the expertise from the private sectors, because they know that they will be updated in the international as well as the essential known things, right? I think you understood what is the need and why it is required, right? So now we will discuss what are the different forms of private sector involvement. There is no proper different forms of private sector involvement, but in some textbook they given related to this. Actually, they given three terms have been used often in describing private sector involvement in water sector. What I thought, first one is privatization. Many times you heard privatization of railway, privatization of transportation, privatization of some other things, life insurance corporations. That is, privatization means what? Referred to as complete handing over to asset, completely whatever the property or whatever structure is there, that will be completely given to private companies, right? They will construct, they will execute, and they will manage, and even the entire property is there with the private organization. That is called as a privatization. Just you have to remember, privatization means what? Complete authority, a complete property asset will be given to private organizations. Next is private sector participation. Second, private sector participation is mainly related to delivering of services. It refers to delivering of services, not entirely given to the private organizations. It will be given, but only part of work, not entire things, even that owned by government, but some services will be given to private organizations. For example, preparation of some identity cards, right? Because technology is not good in government organizations, they will give preparations of any identity cards to some organizations. They will collect all the biodata and all the things, and they will prepare and they will give identity cards, right? For example, PAN card, other cards, right? The service will be given by the private organizations. Next is public-private partnership. Best method of private sector involvement. It is a way, nowadays they are considering it is an ideal form of private sector involvement in the government organizations. Even it is called as a 3P, public-private partnership. And here it is whatever service or whatever it is there, it will be like a joint venture. service will be provided by as from the private sector as well as from the government sectors, right? Next, last portion, it is type of private sector involvements. So here some around 6 types of private sector involvements are there, right? Mainly it is related to private sector organizations. So first type is full divestiture. So full divestiture means it is mainly what we studied, privatization, transfer of all public asset through sale. So here the entire public asset or public property will be sold to private organization through sale, in which case private sector obtain full responsibility of water supply, networks, facilities and operations. So that's what completely sale to private organization. They will take all the responsibilities of construction activities, providing the facilities as well as operations and maintenance. So next is joint venture. So by the name only you can understand, first one is full means completely given to private organizations. So second type is a joint venture. By the name only you can understand, joint means what? Private sector as well as government, and the part of work is given to private sector, right? And the remaining will be with the government. So here partial transfer of asset through sale, resulting in shared ownership and operating responsibilities between private and public sector. For example, we may see in some of the organizations, it is a public organizations, but some part of shares are not completely, maybe 30%, 40% shares of the organizations will be given to private sectors. They will purchase the share and they also become a owner, right? So even they will take a responsibility of risk. For example, if it is company's loss, even private sector will get a loss, even as well as government sector will get a losses, right? That is called as a joint venture. Next is concessions. So in concessions is what? Asset remain in a public ownership. But use of system is concerned to private operators. For example, 20 to 25 years of concession, right? Concession means what? Mainly it is related to property will be in a government hand, it is in the name of government or public asset, but concession will be given to make construction activities, and after that the concession will be given to collect the money. For example, what we studied, financial is required as well as economic aspect is also required. Economic aspect means what? Getting returns back of investment. But how to collect the investment? That is by providing collecting the fees that will be taken by the private organizations. For example, toll connections in the highway, that will be taken from the private organizations. But here the concession will be given only some particular period of years, maybe 20 to 25 years. So next one is BOOT, BOOTS. So here they made short form of build by private sector, operate by private sector, then sometime owned by private sector. After some time they have to transfer the power or all entire thing to the government organizations. That what is called as a BOOT. So here also, if you see the expansion of BOOT, built means built by private sector, operated by private sector, then after that owned by private sector. After some time they have to transfer the entire thing, means infrastructure as well as all the technologies and all the management, to the government organizations, right? So that is called as a BOOT. And one more is there, BOO, build, operate and owned by private organizations. Next, leasing. We know it is very common word in day-to-day activities. Some people, they'll call that house is taken by leasing. Leasing means what? We have to give some leasing means we have to make some investment. After the investment, and they have to get back investment. So when they will get the entire investment back to the organization, then they will give entire property towards the government. For example, if I tell simple language, for example, leasing of house means what? Owner will take around 2 lakh rupees, right? So then they will give a house to who given money to him. Then when owner will give back to that investment, that 2 lakh rupees to them, then they will go from home. So similarly here also, private sector make the investment, then up to they will wait to get all the investment back through fees collection or through tax or through revenue or maybe toll, right? When they will get back the investment, then they will give entire property towards the government. So next is very good method and very non-controversial and very effective method is next step, sixth one. It is contracting out. So by the name only we can understand contracting out. Means we are giving only some part of work to contractors. Maybe for example bill collections, meter readings, right? And maybe it's like repair work, maintenance work, some material providers. These are called as a contracting out. Only part of work is given to some organizations, right? And as we you should not think that it is completely privatization. Even when water services are provided by the private sector, the government still has a key role in providing clear regulatory framework, ensuring that the poor are served and users are protected from excessive cost. So we have fear that even if you provided by private sector, they may give with the high charges. They may not give some facility towards the poor people. That will be controlled by government. Government will take responsibility and they will make such a rules and regulations that all the resource has to be given for all the people. For example, if you see the principle of integrated water resource management. Principles of integrated water resource management is what? Equity. It means we have to take the equality of all the people. From marginalized people to rich people, you have to give equal services. Even what? Then it's a less cost. Then it will take more importance. Why? Because they will give a small financial help for small farmers also. For example, when they want to make a irrigation project, maybe small irrigation project, even farmers can get a loan from the banks, and even they get loans from some financing institute, and even they can take a services from the private organizations to make the irrigation project, and it is taking the very important role, and nowadays it is getting a good effect in a community based organizations also. For example, small farmers, even for domestic use as well as for agriculture use, right? So thank you for watching this video.